Sethuraman S. He completed his undergraduate studies from Tyagarajar College of Engineering. He pursued architecture with almost 5 years of practice and allied 3 years of professional architectural photography. He worked as an architect for Studio Kriya Architects Private Limited, which is a part of TVH Housing, Chennai. And he also worked for the architectural design group, ADG, headed by A.R. Dhanasekaran, Chennai. He's also worked for many other organizations like Design Cube Architects, Carbon Design Consultants, and AIM Associates previously.
Welcome to UGC lecture series for BE Architecture. This is Building Materials 3, AR6304, Unit 3, Types of Concrete Aggregates and Concrete, Part 3, Lecture 7. So, we've looked at the various aggregates that go into concrete, the types of concrete. Now, we're dealing in detail about the types of concrete. Up next are two important and very interesting types of concrete. One, concrete is important because of its very famous application in social housing in Britain. The other is rather more recent and very contemporary form of architecture example. So, two concretes directly in terms of application make it very interesting. So, let us get started. So, the two types of concretes we will be seeing are no fines concrete and fiber reinforced concrete. We will be looking typically at the definitions, the properties, its origins as such, uses, advantages and limitations, and also about the very famous and renowned applications in both cases. Fiber reinforced concrete, the history, the fiber types, properties of the fibers, various advantages and application, and also the famous example. We are looking at a house. This is Britain housing. This is actually a social housing done by the government during post-war times. This is called as the Wimpy's No Fines Houses. So, Wimpy was a construction company which did the social housing. No fines comes from the name of no fines concrete. We've looked at no fines concrete. It simply means that fine aggregates are not used. So, during post-war time, a social housing solution was proposed by Wimpy Construction House using no fines concrete. So, a large set of houses was completely done due to no fines house. So, what makes no fines house very efficient or be a cause or a solution to such a big form of social housing? So, we will be looking into no fines concrete and how this came about. So, I want to also look at this picture. So, no fines concrete means there is no sand. So, there is this very capillary or locked formation of the aggregates, which seemingly allows capillaries or spaces in between, which allows the water to permeate through it. So, usually we look at concrete as a way of repelling moisture or keeping water away, but this in this case seems to allow water. Let us see how that is useful or not for that matter. So, no fines concrete is a method of producing light concrete by omitting the fines. So, that is why it is called no fines. No fines concrete, as the term implies, is a kind of concrete from which the fine aggregates fraction has been omitted totally. So, there is no fine aggregates at all. This concrete is made up of only coarse aggregate, cement and water. So, very often only single size coarse aggregates of size passing through 20 mm retained on 10 mm is used. So, we looked at coarse aggregates. Coarse aggregates can be either single size aggregates or a mixture of single size aggregates. So, in this case for no fines concrete, a single sized aggregates is what is widely used along with water and cement, and particularly 20 mm retained sieve size is used. So, no fines concrete is becoming popular because of some of the advantages it possesses over the conventional concrete. We will see how. The single sized aggregates make a good no fines concrete, which in addition to having large voids and hence light in weight also offers architecturally attractive look. So, we did look at this picture. So, it gives a rugged look. Let us say for the first time in making concrete, it adds an aesthetic value. So, the usual proportion of cement to aggregate is 1:10 in case of heavy aggregate or 1:6 in case of light aggregates. The amount of water should be just sufficient to give a coating of cement paste in all particles. So, you see sand or fine aggregates is what makes it plastic. So, we need to make sure that just the right amount of water is added such that it does not slump off too much. Too little water may leave loose aggregates inside the concrete, and too much of water may cause the cement paste to flow, as I said. So, it is better to wet the aggregate before adding cement and water. So, a little bit of wetting such that you can judge the level of water added and how it is going to set. The concrete should then be mixed thoroughly till all the particles are coated. So, as I said, you add water slowly, mixing it thoroughly to make sure all the particles are coated. This will immediately make the aggregates lock within themselves and thus form the no fines aggregate properties. Properly prepared concrete will not segregate during placing. So, you can see how it's done properly. It does not need any watertight forms also. So, no special method is put into in order to make this locked form. It should not be rammed, but only rodded to remove large capacities. So, while the water is being added, usually ramming or compacting is what is done to make the concrete set properly, but in this case only rodding such that the capillaries fill up evenly is practiced. So, this concrete cannot be easily cut away afterwards and all fixtures etcetera should be placed in the green state. So, even though it has a lot of aesthetic or efficient uses, it does have some restrictions or limitations as well. So, this concrete cannot be cut. As you can see, the person is holding a bit of the no fines concrete. Obviously, you cannot have fixtures added to it after. So, these should already be present in the green state, and it has no resistance to penetration of water, and suitable rendering may be applied on its external surface. So, in case if you want a particular set of the no fines concrete to be resistant to water, suitable finishing or damp proofing or ways to lock the water should be applied. Otherwise, this water permeability is actually used in many ways in terms of no fines concrete. So, properties: it does not segregate because it forms immediately after a locking formation. The density varies with grading of aggregates. So, the aggregates with the absence of fine aggregates makes it the important character for strength and grading. The water cement ratio of this concrete varies from 0.38 to 0.52. Its strength increases with time because it set immediately and the lock or the interlocking forms are produced. It increases with time accordingly. There is very little cohesiveness necessitating longer duration of formwork removal. So, what happens is, as much as it sets hard, the fact that it cannot set on its own without that external support is very clear. So, the formwork that is done to support it should be used for a longer time than usual concrete. Shrinkage of this concrete is lower, obviously, because there is no fine aggregate compacting or moving out. So, the shrinkage is very less than normal concrete and its thermal expansion is about 0.6 to 0.8 of normal concrete. So, whatever fine aggregate is generally imparting in terms of character to concrete is all kind of reduced in this no fines concrete forms. Thus, the uses of no fines concrete: construction of external load bearing walls, construction of small retaining walls, damp proof material, construction of temporary structures. So, these are very common uses of no fines concrete. Some advantages based on the characteristics and uses: no fines concrete exhibit less drying shrinkage as compared to ordinary concrete, which we just saw. Movement of water due to capillary action is negligible in this type of concrete. Water doesn't get trapped. It does allow water to permeate through it, but the general problem or the general damage done to concrete by moisture or water is when water gets trapped in between the concrete. So, that doesn't happen because capillary action does not happen in this case. Due to its lightweight nature, it is used in lightweight concrete construction. So, obviously, it becomes lightweight because of the presence of no fines and interlocking forms. So, this aids in low lightweight constructions. Thermal insulating characters of no fines concrete is better than conventional concrete. This is why it is used in the construction of external wall. So, the common uses by external walls are temporary structures. So, this is because the thermal capability of these no fine concrete walls are much better than normal concretes. Furthermore, the advantages would be this type of concrete results in saving of material requirement. Obviously, there is no fine aggregate, so that eliminates the use of fine aggregate, its cost, its transport and every other form of factor that affects fine aggregates. The density of this type of concrete is about 25% to 30% less than the conventional concrete. So, the density is much lesser, so it exerts less pressure on formwork. So, even though the formwork is required for a longer period of time, the pressure exerted by the concrete as such on formwork when compared to conventional concrete is much, much lesser. Segregation property of this type of concrete is very low. So, we discussed that one of the properties or advantages of no fines concrete is that there is no segregation as such. Therefore, it can be dropped from considerable height without the danger of segregation. When this is compacted, it can be actually transported from one point to another without being damaged even in case of dropping. So, no special equipment is needed for compaction of this concrete. So, just formwork, placing formwork is more than enough. And as I said, compaction is not necessary, just rodding will be more than enough. So, other advantages will be highly permeable to water. It absorbs rainwater and facilitates its natural runoff. A concrete being permeable to water opens up a lot of advantages in terms of water permeability, in terms of absorbing moisture, absorbing rainwater and it facilitates natural runoff. So, instead of having an actual slope to have the water runoff in terms of rain, what happens is actually the water passes directly through the no-fines concrete, making it very easy and also helpful in terms of collecting groundwater. It reduces the risk of flooding in heavy rain. So, when you have a pavement or when you have the outer area surrounded by no-fines concrete, it simply acts as a layer through which water can pass through to the ground. It quickly redirects rainfall runoff from roads and walkways. So, not only domestic, it can be extended to roads and walkways. It reduces pollution in stormwater due to filtering access. So, this is another thing. Water, when it flows off in runoff or in case of rainwater, it does have a lot of impurities. So, we have to actually pass it through various levels of filtration, sedimentation level filtration. But in this case, no fine concrete actually traps all these impurities or any form of pollution. Lower cost due to lower cement content. So, there is formation of cement with reaction to water, but there is no fine aggregate. So, this reduces the cement content that reacts, and therefore, the cement content is used much lesser. The better insulating characteristics than conventional concrete is an important factor because there are presence of large voids. So, we talked about the voids in between. So, this helps in insulating factors. So, you can see water demonstrated directly. You pour water over a bed of or a slab of no fines concrete, and the water passes through directly. Obviously, there are some limitations as to in the case of any other type of concrete. Due to absence of fine aggregate, this type of concrete lacks cohesiveness while in plastic state. So, when we are actually setting or mixing it, the plasticity is actually absent, totally absent in case of no fines concrete because there is no sand. So, therefore, it requires long time for formwork removal, which we discussed. It is more permeable than conventional concrete. Therefore, walls constructed with no fines concrete need an extra coat of mortar. So, as far as the pavement or water runoff is necessary, no fines concrete was very helpful. But in case you are using no fines concrete for walls, we have to add an extra layer of damp proofing or a method to be able to contain the moisture. Generally, reinforcement is not recommended in this type of concrete. However, if it is required to use reinforcement, a thin layer of cement paste on the reinforcement before using it. So, directly adding reinforcement does not help to get locked into this form. So, we have to add a cement so that the so it becomes a little plastic in order to adjust with this form of concrete. Only then will it improve the bonding of steel with the concrete and also resistant to corrosion. So, these are some limitations, and there are no standard tests because it is a simple formation method. Only by proper visual inspection and trial and error method, one can judge its workability. So, this is also a big limitation in terms of no fines concrete. So, as I said, we'll now talk about the Wimpy no fines house. So, this is another example of the housing where the no fines concrete was used. You can see the actual the balcony wall that is being done is done with the use of no fines concrete. We rarely find this in any type of buildings. So, this is a very good example, and this was actually widespread followed during the post war period, done exclusively by the government of Britain. So, there were a lot of problems with respect to the Wimpy no fine houses because not because of the no fines concrete, but because of the window sizes as such. So, these Wimpy no fines houses have been retrofitted in many ways, but the basic or the underlying no fines concrete is still very much intact, which shows that no fines concrete is very much used and it has a lot of advantages. And so, this is a retrofitted rather very recent example of the no fines housing. So, the no fines housing was a construction method and series of house designs produced by George Wimpy Company and intended for mass production of social housing for families developed under the Ministry of Works post World War. So, emergency factor made program, no fines referred to the type of concrete used, concrete with no fine aggregates. No fines houses were built with a 10 inch concrete shell cast in situ. So, in the site, the no fines concrete was cast and it was used for walls. So, not only is it used for slabs, it was very extensively used for walls and the whole structure. The concrete for the entire outer structure was cast in one operation, so which is another advantage in terms of time consumption. The ground floor was concrete and still is. The first floor was made with traditional timber joists and floor boards. So, that is the Wimpy no fines house, a very widespread example of the no fines concrete use. Okay, so, another very interesting type of concrete and a rather very contrasting to the no fines is fiber reinforced concrete. If you look at this picture, you can see what capability fiber reinforced concrete offers to building industry. We'll look at its properties, its uses, its origins, etc., and also look at this interesting example of a building. So, fiber reinforced concrete. So, concrete, as you see, it's been used with different types of aggregates. It's been used with polymers. It's been used with air bubbles, and so there's also a way of using it with reinforcements. And fiber reinforcements is one of the famous ways of using reinforcements in concrete. So, we'll be looking at that. Plain Portland cement is a brittle material, which we all know. So, the strength of concrete in tension is much lower than in compression. A growing tensile crack in plain concrete can very soon lead to failure. In the presence of reinforcement, the tensile load is transferred to the steel. So, RCC, reinforced cement concrete, which was so widely used, uses steel reinforcement. But an alternative to this, which adds to the plasticity, increased plasticity, is fiber reinforcement. So, an alternative to increasing the load carrying capacity of concrete in tension is the addition of fibers. So, fibers are added to these concretes to make it better. So, fibers can be natural fibers as well as artificial fibers. What is done is well dispersed fibers in the concrete act to bridge the cracks that develop in concrete. So, the biggest factor of cracking is controlled with the use of dispersed fiber. So, very controlled dispersed fibers in the use of concrete is practiced. The incorporation of fibers in a cement matrix leads to an increase in toughness and tensile strength and an improvement in the cracking and deformation characteristics of the resultant concrete. So, you can see the ultimate strength of concrete is improved by adding fibers. So, this makes it a very interesting type of concrete and also a very useful one. Fiber reinforced concrete, FRC as it is called, is concrete containing fibrous material which increases its structural integrity. So, there are various fibers. Fiber includes steel fibers, glass fibers, synthetic fibers and natural fibers. So, as I said, there are artificial fibers and there are natural fibers. So, each of the fibers have different characteristics and lend different properties to the concrete. The concept of using fibers or as reinforcement is not new. Fibers have been used as reinforcements since ancient times. So, horse hair has been used in a lot of building material, especially in mud construction, etcetera. So, this is a way of using natural fiber. So, this is what is being researched and taken further to development, and artificial fibers are being used now. So, the health risks associated with asbestos. So, yeah. So, after horse hair, the development led to asbestos being used for fiber additions. After a point of time, asbestos was found to be very hazardous in terms of health concerns. So, this was replaced by the fibers which are used today. So, the fibers which are used today are steel, glass and synthetic fibers apart from natural fibers. So, we will go through a brief history. This is one of the pavilion exhibitions that was conducted during the time of Le Corbusier, and the office of Le Corbusier was supposed to make a design for this pavilion. Le Corbusier was apparently not available, and one of his architects, Senekes, was the one who did it. So, this is actually a pavilion that uses sound as an inspiration and is a prime example of music converted to architecture. This is a very documented and modern use of fiber reinforced concrete. This is called the Philips Pavilion, and this was obviously done for the Philips company to exhibit their lights in the form of acoustic measures. So, the fiber types are discussed now. The steel fibers can be straight, twisted, hooked. These are the most common used. Glass fibers are generally straight. Natural organic and mineral fibers, which we talked about, wood, cotton, bamboo and rock wool are used. Furthermore, polypropylene fibers, plain, twisted, fibrillated types, synthetic fibers such as Kevlar, nylon and polyester were used. So, the types of fibers we saw. Steel, you can see that the hooked type of steel fibers are used, and glass fibers, which are just straight fibers. So, the properties of fiber reinforced concrete are manifold. Obviously, the first and foremost being the modulus of elasticity. It becomes more plastic because of the fibrous content present throughout the concrete. Flexure was supposed to be increased 2.5 times because the plasticity is increased. Toughness again is about 10 to 40 times better than that of plain concrete. Splitting tensile strength. So, usually it was compressive strength that was increased by varying the type of concrete. In this case, the tensile strength has been increased many times better. Compressive strength. The presence of fibers may alter the failure mode of cylinders, but the fiber effect will be minor on the improvement of compressive strength. Impact resistance for fibrous concrete is generally 5 to 10 times that of plain concrete. So, making it fibrous and rather evenly distributed, make sure that it is at least 5 to 10 times more impact resistant. So, you can see this is after very large amounts of impact that you see that it is able to crack, that too only up till an extent without causing much damage that too. Corrosion is also resisted to a great extent. So, we will be talking about how the fiber or the characteristics of the fiber affects the particular fiber reinforced contract. Type of fiber, the material and the texture, the volume concentration of the fiber, aspect ratio of the fiber, orientation of the fiber in the matrix are some important ways in which the fiber affects the type of concrete. So, some advantages, we looked at nylon fibers and propylene fibers. These help improve the mix cohesion, they improve the freeze thaw resistance, they improve resistance to explosive spilling, they improve impact resistance. Steel reinforcement are very much reduced, it improves the ductility as a result. So, crack widths and the control over the crack widths is improved and the durability is thus improved as a result. So, steel fibers can improve the structural strength, it can reduce the steel in reinforcement required, it improves impact and abrasion and it also improves the freeze thaw resistance. So, the most primary applications of fiber reinforced concrete is not domestic architecture or residential architecture or even mass construction, it is used for more infrastructure kind of architecture. Runways, aircraft parking and pavements, tunnel lining and slopes stabilization, blast resistant structures. So, this is blast resistant structures are something being researched a lot in the present conditions. So, FRC is a very good blast resistant concrete. Thin shells, walls, pipes and manholes are also applications. Dams and hydraulic structures. So, you can see how fibrous concretes can be shaped because of the plasticity and the modulus of elasticity that they can offer. So, the photo or the picture that I showed you was that of the Haydar Aliyev Center by Zaha Hadid Architects. So, let us look at how this form was arrived. Zaha Hadid Architects was appointed as design architects of the Haydar Aliyev Center following a competition in 2007. So, the center designed to become the primary building for nations cultural programs breaks from the rigid and often monumental Soviet architecture that is prevalent in Baku. So, in Russia this was built. The design of the center established a continuous fluid relationship between its surrounding plaza and the building interiors. You can see that the overall form is fluid and it is also structural in its character. So, one of the most critical yet challenging elements of the project was the architectural development of the building skin. So, you can look at the skin. So, this was actually enabled better by the fiber reinforced concrete system. So, the space frame system enabled the construction of free form structure and saved significant time throughout the construction process. So, the two most important materials used were glass fiber reinforced concrete and glass fiber reinforced polyester. So, fiber reinforcement was an important element. We just discussed about various fiber reinforced concrete and glass was one of them. So, this is a direct application of glass fiber reinforced concrete in a project, that too by Zaha Hadid. These allow for the powerful plasticity of the building. We talked about plasticity that fiber reinforcement offers for the concrete. So, this allows for the powerful plasticity of the building's design while responding to a variety of different functional demands related to a variety of situations, plaza, transition zones and envelopes. So, you can see how very fluid this form is. So, fiber reinforced concrete is a way to facilitate this. So, we looked at two different applications and how these concretes enable them. So, with this we come to the outcomes of this particular lecture. We were able to understand the types of concretes and their special uses. A brief study of origin, developments and history of the no fines type of concrete. So, the Wimpy no fines houses, hope you can remember that because that was a very wide used no fines concrete method. So, a glimpse at the Wimpy houses which were the first mass housing using no fines type of concrete. Studying the evolution of fiber reinforced concrete and its properties. So, we saw how fiber can reinforce concrete and add elasticity and plasticity. A look at its application and brief study of the famous Aliyev Center by Zaha Hadid Architects. So, some exercises which you can do are literature studies as well as some live studies. Making a live sample of no fines concrete in the construction lab. So, making no fines concrete is a very easy thing to do. So, you could actually try that in the construction yard. A literature study of the Wimpy no fines houses and its shortcomings. An attempt at creating a sample of fiber reinforced concrete using hemp or steel hooks in the construction lab. So, creating a fiber reinforced concrete is not easy, but you'd give it a try in order to understand how the basic relationship between fibers and the concrete works. Literature study of the Heda Aliyev Center by Zahadid Architects. With this, we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you.